Welcome back to Python with Andrew, where we'll continue looking at functions or the basics of functions as a building block to creating some really good, powerful programs. And as you've seen, if you've seen the other videos on functions, I like to keep them short and very, very, very focused in on doing one little task and then using it as many times as I need to. In this particular video, we're going to look at a bit further with functions and how we can use it to return answers. At this point, we've only used functions to print things onto the screen. Now we're going to use it to return answers. Okay, so let's jump over to our code. Now, of course, we've already seen a few functions that return values. The input function is a really good example. But let's create a simple function, define add. I'm going to call it add, and it's going to take two numbers, x and y, and guess what? It's going to return x plus y. Okay. Now, what's different with this function definition is I'm using this keyword called return. Okay, and return sends back to whoever called the function the value that I say to return. If I don't have a value there, it returns nothing. But if I have a value, it's going to return that value. In this case, it's going to return x plus y. All right? So if I call this add 10, 2, it's going to return 10 plus 2. Now, of course, at the moment, if I clear that code, it's going to do nothing with it. I just said return it. But now if I print that, let's go up and print whatever I returned. So now we're saying print the result of calling that function or print whatever it is returning. If I do that, we should get 12. Lucky my math is okay. And equally, if we print add 20 plus 3, comma, add 20 plus 24, right? I've done two calls of the function, both of them return, and if I run that, we should get 12 again and 23 and 23. So you can see I'm now returning a value from a function, and the value is whatever I put in that return statement. Now, the way to think of it, let me get rid of this one, is if I call the function, I'm going to replace that with the answer. So if I'm calling with add 10 plus 12, it's the equivalent of, because we know the answer, it's the equivalent of replacing the function with the answer or with the result. Now, of course, we know what the result is for x plus y because it's very easy. It would get more and more complex if we had more and more complex functions. Right? Now, up here in my return statement, I could have done x plus y. I could say z equals x plus y. Right? And I can return z. Okay. That's exactly the same. Imagine if that z equals x plus y is much, much more complex. So I'm doing some formulas, I'm doing some activity, and then I'm returning the value. If I do that, I should get exactly the same again. Of course, this is not much use anymore. It's exactly the same. I'll clear it and do it again. Okay, so that's a simple return of one answer. We can return multiple answers, and I'll touch on that another time, but the thing to remember is inside the function, if I want to return some values, sooner or later I need to return. Okay, now let's see what happens if I return without a value, right? So in that case, I'm returning from the function, which is the same as, you know, ending. And if I run it, it returns a special word called none, right? Or nothing, it's null, okay? So it does return, an answer, but it's sort of, it's not very useful in this particular case. And so let's put Z there. Now I can create another function. Let's make it a bit more complex. And this time I'm going to total a list. And I'm going to take a list in. And I'm going to set the total equals 0. And then for all the numbers, for a number in list, all the numbers, I'm going to go total equals total plus number. Okay. And then down the bottom here, I'm going to return the total. Okay, so there's an example where, and I've just got a space in there for the looks. There is a example where I'm doing the calculations a bit more complex, still not very complex. I'm taking something in a bit more interesting here, but I'm returning one value. So now if I print total list, and I set in a list, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hopefully, if I've done my programming correctly, I get the answer 15, which is 1 + 2 + 3 + 4 + 5. So I'm going through the list and adding up the numbers, and I'm returning the numbers. Now, what I like about this sort of idea, and this is a very simple program, but you can see I've defined a very small function. It's to do one job and one job only. In this case, it's going to go through a list and add the numbers. And I like that. Make very short functions, 5 lines, 10 lines, you know, few lines as possible. Make it nice and clean and document it. And we'll talk a lot more about documentation as we go along so that we can hand it over to someone else. And then call the function once, or we could have called this, you know, many times. Let's change the 24. I could change that, and I get 2 calls, and I could have called it many, many times. So I like the idea, short, sharp functions, bring in the values through arguments, and in the function definition, use those parameters, do the work you need to do, and then return an answer. Sometimes the answer is going to be a number. Sometimes the answer is going to be true or false. We could define a function like this. Define is 10, all right? And this takes a number X. And all this does is return if X is equal to 10, return true, else return false. Okay. So very simple function. In fact, it doesn't really do much. It checks if a number is equal to 10, and if it is, returns true. If it's not, it returns false. Is 10, 10. So we'd expect that to be true. And let's create one that says is 11, is 10, 11. So we'd expect to get the answer. Let me get rid of these here. I don't run them. So I've got my function definition there, and I'm testing it here. And hopefully, if I run it correctly, I should get true for the first one, false for the second one. Okay, so that's actually a really good way of, if you like, returning values. Is it 10 or not? And I could use that further on. And again, you'll see it's a very short function. It does one thing, not very valuable at this point, but it also means that I can use it many, many times. And the return value is the thing I'm after. When I call this, this is replaced by the answer, which is true. Now I'm going to print it out. Okay, so I can call a function within a function within a function, as long as at the end I am doing something with it. Okay, so functions, incredibly powerful. We can pass, we can define a function that has parameters that we do things with to make it more and more general. We can define a function that returns one answer or many answers. And we can, if you like, make that function the building blocks of the work. Okay. And simply to show you how to return two values, as an example, let's create the return two. I'm going to call it return two. And it's going to take X and Y. And this function is going to return, if you like, Y, X. Okay. Now, all this is doing is effectively reversing the two. Okay, so now if I comment these out and print, what happens if I call print return 2, 10, 20? All right, let's see what that does. It brings back 20, 10 as a tuple. So it's easy to return multiple values with commas. And it comes back as a tuple, right? And yeah, I've got a video on tuples so you can see how you can unpack the tuple. Now, this function, again, it doesn't do much. It just flips them around, but that doesn't matter. We could have made it a much more complex function. I just wanted to demonstrate quickly how we can return two values or more values, okay? Very, very easy to do. Python's one of the few languages that allow you to return values. So in Python, a function can return nothing, which is like the print, right? It puts to the screen, it doesn't return anything. It can return one value or it can return many values. So it makes it really, really powerful, but also really, really easy to use. So that's all on this particular one on functions. I hope you enjoyed it. Do subscribe and have a great day. Cheers.